Hello, Dominic from BMT Spain, and today we do the two-handed backhand, whip your backhand. So I will do the four same steps as we did in the one-handed backhand and in the forehand. So I got my own whip again. So you take an old racket, you cut off the grip. The racket is open. You can put a small horse whip in it with some silicone, and you have your own whip. So the good part of it is that you can take the whip like you hold your racket and you get the same feeling. Now, how do we start? We make some movements. If you don't hear the noise, it means or you hold the racket too hard or you hold the racket too loose. Now, on the power from 1 to 10, you take the racket between 3 and 5. So at that moment between 3 and 5, you can control your racket. And that's when you will get the noise. So if you hear the noise, it means that you grip the racket well. So today for the two-handed backhand whip it, I will do it different than my other video. I will use my 10-year-old student, Martina. So let's bring Martina in. So here we have Martina. She will do the four steps in the backhand. So first she will start in the contact point. Just making the hand movement. So she will start in contact point. We will do 5 strokes straight and we will do 5 strokes open position. So first she will do 5 straight with the notification that the back of the hand will be on top the moment she finished the hand movement. So let's check it out. Give me 5. Voila. And here you can see, stop. Here you can see this hand should turn a little bit more. So from contact point, 3, 4, 5. Now we will do the open position. We will do the open position, contact point, the arm, the hand, the back of the hand is coming up. 3, 4, and 1 more, 5. So this is the step 1. We go to step 2. Now the racket will come from further and we will find that same spot where we started our hand motion. And we will start to whip the racket because we have more speed in this movement. The arm will be more stretched to the front, but we still are going to watch the back of our hand. So again, 5 from the back, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we do 5 open position from the back, 1, whip it, 2, whip it. Oh, we want to hear the noise. 4, 5. So this is the second step. The second step, we will start to use the racket. Now we will do 5 straight positions with that racket. From the back. No, we don't finish. Just the part you did. 1, 2, 3. And again, we will check out if the hand has turned. The back of the hand is on top, so that's a good movement. Now we will do 5 in the open position, again from the back, and we finish, we check out if the hand is on top, that's okay. She doesn't listen, you whip her a little bit so she have more attention. Yes, very good. Okay, now step 3, we will do the same. We go from the back, we whip the racket, but we will finish. So find it, whip it, and finish. Whip it, give me some more noise. Yeah, I need more noise. Yes, I need more noise. That's the one. That's the one. 5 open positions now. And again, we want to hear the noise. See? So the faster she's accelerating, you can see that the weight is making that transfer from the left to the right foot also. So 5, very good. We will do the same. 5 movements with the racket now to that finish. Voila. And whip that racket, very good. See how the racket is accelerating, good. Now, 5 open positions. And again, if she goes well, we will see the transfer of the legs here. Whip that racket, very good. 1 more. Now we will do the last step, the complete stroke. We start here in the power position. We go back, find it, whip it, and we will finish. Again, we do 5. In the straight position, and we need to hear that lovely noise of the whip. 4, 5, open position. 1, 2, good. 3, 4, and 5. Very good. And again, we go and we take the racket and we repeat. It's also good for muscle memory. 5 strokes, and you can hear, you can already hear the noise of the racket coming. 1 more. 5 open position. And again, we see the weight transfer, which is very good. Accelerate. 2 more. 1 and 2. Very good. Now, I will feed some balls. I didn't do that in the other video, but she will start now. I will throw her some balls. She will start in the back and she will just finish in the front. So she has a good idea of finding the contact and whipping the racket through the ball, finishing with the palm of the hand in the back. So let's check out how she's doing with the ball. Controla solo buscas y lanzas, buscar y lanzar, bien, bien, buscar y lanzar. Yeah. She's closing too early, so we could see that the moment she starts to throw, yeah, if you start the throwing action too early, if you start the throwing action already here, the racket starts to close, and that's why the two balls went into the net. So this is the main part now, finding the right moment to start that whipping action against the ball. If you are too early, you're starting too close and you hit in the net. If you do it too late, it has no influence on the ball. So finding that point every time to whip that racket against the ball. Now she will do the same, but she will finish. I will feed her another 5 balls and then we go in the back. So now the same exercise, but finishing the stroke. So she should find the point where she should start the throwing action. Find it, throw it and finish. Find it, throw it and finish. There she throw too early. That's a good one. Find it, whip the backhand. Yes, find it and whip the backhand. So this was better. We go in the back and she will make the whole movement now. So we will start and check out the bounce if we can. So what's up now? Here we go, another 5. We will do the bounce and the turn. Then she finds it and she whips it. Yeah, she whips it. As a speed she can control. That's how we get. She controls this speed. It's about 50% of her normal speed. Now 2 more, control. And 1 more. So this is the speed she can control. We will do now 75% of her speed. So she will go faster. Not full speed, but she will go faster in the whipping action. That's a nice backhand. Now whip it faster. That's a nice one. Now go and whip it. So at this speed she can control her backhand. Yeah. Voila, these are nice backhands. So now she will go full speed. And normally we will see here a few more mistakes. I hope not, but let's check it out. So, dame todo, vale? So, whip it. There you see the first mistake. That's a nice one. Whip it. That's a nice one. Whip it. That's a nice one. So, this is the whipping two-handed backhand with a demonstration. And so next time you go out, you take the 4 steps, you start in the contact point, you find it and you whip it, you find it, you whip it and you finish, then the bounce and the turn, find it and whip it. These are the 4 progression steps. I hope you enjoyed the video and see you in another video. Thank you for watching.